I am sorry your people died today. You have been sailing.
Yes.
Imagine yourself looking out at the vast sea before you. You reach down and you put a hand into the water and you scoop it up towards you. Immediately the water starts leaking through your fingers until the hand is empty. That water is a man's life. From birth to death, it is always slipping through our hands until it is gone. Along with all that you hold dear in this world. And yet the kingdom I speak of, and I live for, is like the rest of the water out in the sea. Man lives for that cup of water that slips through his fingers. The ghost that follow Jesus Christ live for that endless expanse of sea.
What if, after all this, I still do not believe in your Christ?
I wasn't trying to convince you. Listen to me. There's only a moment. It's not me. It is Christ himself that looks upon you and shudders your defenses. And in that moment, you will understand that you are completely known by God. That you are completely loved. I will pray that moment comes for you.
But at midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the prisoners were listening to them. Suddenly, there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prison were shaken, and immediately all the doors were opened, and everyone's chains were loosed, and the keeper of the prison, awaking from sleep and seeing the prison doors open, supposing the prisoners had fled, drew his sword and was about to kill himself. But Paul called with a loud voice, saying, "Do yourself no harm, for we are all here." Then he called for a light, ran in, and fell down trembling before Paul and Silas. And he brought them out and said, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved?" So they said, "Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and you will be saved, you and your household." Then they spoke the word of the Lord to him and to all who were in his house. And he took them the same hour of the night and washed their stripes. And immediately he and all his family were baptized. Now when he had brought them in his house, he set food before them, and he rejoiced, having believed in God with all his household.